All right, so let's play a game. In the book Great Expectations by Charles Dickens, we encounter a very dark yet intriguing character that brings to life one of those feelings that we universally shared as human beings, heartbreak. Dickens' novel revolves around Pip's expectations through his life, but we also get to know a character named Amelia Havisham. Amelia was a very rich woman who had inherited most of her father's fortune. And she had fallen blindly in love with a man named Compeyson. Compeyson's sole purpose was to steal her riches, though. So, although Amelia had been forewarned about Compeyson's possible ulterior motives, she ultimately decided to put her heart first before anything else, including her rationality. On her wedding day, she received a letter from Compeyson himself stating that he indeed had defrauded her and that he was leaving her at the altar. In some type of emotional breakdown, she simply decided to never remove her dress and only wear one shoe, because that's exactly what she was wearing when she had learned of Compeyson's betrayal. She even set out all of the clocks in her mansion to 20 minutes till 9, because that's the exact time of when she had learned of Compeyson's betrayal. She even let the wedding cake out until it'll turn to mold and dust, because that's the exact same way the table was arranged when she had learned of Compeyson's betrayal. To a certain extent, it is very easy to try to relate to Amelia's heartbreak. Now, I'm not saying that I will leave rotten food on the table like that, but what I'm saying is I'll probably grab a bottle of wine, put some Adele songs on, and cry my eyes out for a couple of days. Heartbreak is a very convoluted feeling to unpack. That feeling of being undone by someone just walking out on us. Our heart may sink as we come to the realization that the person who we unconditionally loved simply decides to give up on us. Heartbreak can also make us act very irrational. This is the period of time where we may do very stupid things, such as calling our ex in the middle of the night, leaving drunken voicemails, or, you know, even rereading those loving text messages we once sent back to each other, just reminiscing and wondering where and what did everything go wrong. Irrationality, or the constant lack of judgment in decision making, is one of the pillars of game theory. So, game theory is the branch of mathematics and economics that teaches us economists how to study decision making. That is, we're trying to answer the question, why do people make the choices that they do? And to a large extent, people make the choices that they do because that's what makes them happy. Now, is crying your eyes out a choice that will make you happy? Of course not. We are not just a bunch of algorithms that can get the right answer all the time. We have feelings. We're altruistic, we get wounded, and we're healing from wounds right now. At the end of the day, we are very, very complex individuals. But what if I told you that game theory can actually help us get over a heartbreak? Obviously, this wouldn't be a quick fix or a magic pill, but it will have to be a process that will have to be repeated over and over again until it all makes sense. So, let's start from the point of heartbreak. When our heart is broken, the initial reaction is to be overwhelmed with emotions. Crying is understandable. Talking on hours on end with a friend is understandable. Even planning out a revenge body is understandable. However, I think that heartbreak happens because there is an enormous information asymmetry. That is, we know how we feel and what we did in the relationship, but we don't really know how they feel and the rationale behind their choices. Of course, it's easy to look inwards and, you know, try to rationalize from our point of view. We may think about the good times we had at holiday parties with our families. We may think about the good times we had at cute dates by the Chicago River, or those days we spent watching Netflix the entire day by the sofa. Reaffirming and reimagining all of these old memories and thoughts at this point in time is one of the least productive things one could do because it doesn't address the point of our heartbreak. Now, the decision-making system that we have in place has been developed along since we were children. So since a very young age, we ultimately developed a type of decision-making system that grew with us as we became adults. We did good things, we might have received good things. We did bad things, and we may have some pushback. So it is at this point in time where we develop some type of decision-making system compass that guides us through adulthood. So at the end of the day, everybody in this room is working on some type of autopilot decision-making system that has been ingrained with us since we were children. And just as we are running on this type of autopilot decision-making system, so is our ex-partner. And I think it is here where the hardest pill to swallow can be found. That is, in order to understand the question, why did they leave us, we will need to understand every single thing that there is to know about them. We will need to know every single detail that has led them to the people they are today. We will need to understand the nurturing and the type of the relationship they have with their parents and siblings. We need to understand their deepest passions. We need to understand their darkest secrets. We need to understand the wounds that they have healed from. We need to understand who they want to be as a person at the end of the day. We need to understand how they see us in their lives and how do we play a role into their lives. We are all participants in the game of love. That is, we are all playing by our own rules and we want different things out of it. Some people may be looking for long-term companionship, while others may be looking for short-term affection. Some people may be looking for someone to take care of them, while others may be looking for someone to take care of. So, as we venture into this love game, the chances of finding someone that perfectly matches our senses is pretty much irrational. So the next time you actually get that Tinder match, the probability of that person being the one for you is probably zero. So let's go back into comparison and Amelia's type of game, right? So we understand that comparison had two choices. We knew that comparison had a choice not to betray and or to betray. And Amelia, at the end of the day, also had two choices, to continue living her life or to get stuck in a loop of sadness. So the game can actually be arranged in this manner. At the start of the game, Compassion has two choices. If he chooses to, you know, to not betray her, the game ends and they live happily ever after. However, if he chooses to betray her, then Amelia has two choices. She can either get stuck in a loop of sadness, or she can just move on with her life. As we saw in the rest of the novel, the ultimate outcome of the game was this, where Compassion decided to betray her, and Amelia ultimately decided to get stuck in that, you know, sadness state of mind. So, fine, this is the result of the game. But what about Compassion's backstory? We know that he had a choice. We know that he could go either way. So it is at this point in time when we truly need to see who Compassion is as a person and why is he the man he is today. So in order to understand better, we need to sort of, you know, extrapolate back into his lifetime, right? So we kind of have to see, you know, what played into the role that made him the man that he is today. And so maybe it has something to do with the type of nurturing that he had as a child, or maybe it has to do something with the romance between their parents or their grandparents. You know, there is an intricacies of plethora of options that could play out into who he is today. And only by understanding all of these factors, we will get to the answer, why did Compassion betray Amelia? Now, just as we are analyzing this situation, we also realize that there are multiple versions of compassion. We ultimately know that he decided to betray her, and that's the end of the game, but what about all of the hypothetical versions of who he could have been? He could have been any one of those options by just simple tweaks in compassion's past. And this is where we actually find nested interactions, where someone made a choice in the past, and that made compassion the man that he is today. So it is at this point where we're trying to make an understanding for our ex-partner. Just as we're analyzing compassion in this manner, we kind of have to put our ex-partner in this same platform, where we truly get to realize that there is complexities all around in order to understand why did they decide to leave us. Now, Amelia also had a choice to either move on with her life or to get stuck in a loop of sadness. It is at this point where we say, well, Amelia ultimately decided to get stuck in a loop of sadness, so then what? Amelia's actions actually cause more heartbreak and chaos in the rest of the novel. We can actually see that she tarnished the relationship between Pip and Estella, her adopted daughter, ultimately causing Pip's heartbreak and Estella to run with some men. We actually see that just as people have effects on us, we have effects on other people. Heartbreak doesn't have to be filled with sadness. A broken heart can actually teach us how to be more understanding, and understanding that there is complexities to the decision-making of other people. So, next time you encounter a broken heart, instead of running to old memories trying to seek comfort, try to make understandings that making choices is very difficult, and we will never be able to get to the question, why did they decide to leave us? Because that's such an impossible question to answer. We can only be responsible for our own choices and the ramifications of those choices. Thank you.